الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم على محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. My dear respected brothers and sisters, إن شاء الله تعالى we're going to continue benefiting from these tremendous principles in the affairs of العقيدة. The affairs of the creed and the methodology that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his companions and the righteous predecessors were upon. The author rahimahullah ta'ala here, he is talking about one of the principles from the principles of aqidah, that it is not permissible to indulge in argumentation when it comes to the affairs of al-qadr, the predestination and the predecree. وقوله والكلام والجدال والخصومة في القدر خاصة منهي عنه. عرفنا أن الإيمان بالقضاء والقدر بدرجاته ركن من أركان الإيمان بالله، فمن لم يؤمن بالقضاء والقدر فليس بمؤمن، لأنه جحد ركنا من أركان الإيمان. The author رحمه الله تعالى he said, and to indulge in speaking an argumentation about the affairs of al-qadr in particular is something prohibited. Sheikh Saleh bin Fuzan al-Fuzan, hafidhahullah ta'ala, he said, we have already defined and spoke about al-Iman when it comes to Al-Iman when it comes to Al-Qadr, the affair of Al-Qadr, the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the levels and its levels. He said that Al-Qadr is one of the pillars of Al-Iman. As you know, Al-Iman is six pillars. Al-Iman is six pillars. The first pillar is to believe in Allah. The second pillar is to believe in his books. The third pillar is to believe in his angels, peace be upon them. And the fourth pillar is to believe in his prophet messengers. And the fifth pillar is to believe in the last day. And the sixth pillar, which is this one, to believe in al-qadr, to believe in the pre-decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. خيره وشره, the good of it or the bad of it. This is from Iman. This is from Al-Iman. And from the pillars of Al-Iman is to believe in Al-Qadr, to believe in the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whatever Allah has pre-decreed subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Sheikh said, whoever does not believe in the predestination, he does not believe in Al-Qadr, then this person is not a believer. Because he had rejected one of the pillars of al-Iman. وكذلك لا يجوز الجدال في القضاء والقدر. لماذا يعذب الله كذا؟ لماذا يفعل الله كذا؟ كما سبق أنه لا يقال لما وكيف. He said, Sheikh Saleh Fawzan حفظه الله, he said, likewise, speaking about the affairs of al-qadr and arguing and disputing in the affairs of al-qadr. Like, for example, someone may say, why would Allah punish so-and-so? And why would Allah do this? And so on and so forth. And this had preceded from the author, rahimahullah. that it is not permissible to say why and how and the like. This is not from the way of Al-Sunnah. We don't question the actions of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we don't question His pre-decree. فَلَا يُعَرَّضُ عَلَى اللَّهِ وَلَا تَدْخُلُ فِي الْقَضَاءِ وَالْقَدَرِ بِالْجِدَالِ فَإِنَّكَ لَنْ تَصِلَ إِلَى نَتِيجَةِ. So he said, it is not permissible to oppose the actions of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His decree. Not permissible to do that. And do not enter into this affair of al-qadr. Do not enter into it with argumentation and disputation and the like. He said, because you're not going to reach any result. You're not going to reach any result. فَعَلَيْكَ التَّسْلِيمِ وَالْإِيمَانِ وَلَا تَدْخُلْ فِي أَمْرٍ مِنْ أُمُورِ اللَّهِ. What is upon you is to submit. What is upon you is to submit. And do not enter and do not indulge in these affairs of al-qadr. Do not indulge yourself in these affairs. لِأَنَّ هَذَا لَا يَعْلَمُهُ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Because this only Allah knows about it. You don't know anything about al-qadr. Only Allah knows. جَلَّ وَعَلَى. وَلَنْ تَنْتَهِي إِلَى نَتِيجَةٍ. And you're not going to reach any results. Nothing. You're not going to accomplish anything. Because you have no knowledge about القضاء والقدر. وَلِهَذَا يُقَالَ الْقَدَرُ سِرُّ اللَّهِ. فَسِرُّ اللَّهِ لَا يُدْرَكُ وَلَا يُحَاطُ بِهِ أَبَدًا. So he said, Sheikh Saleh Fawzan, حَفِظَهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى, he said, and that is why they say that the people of knowledge, some of the people of knowledge, they say, Al-Qadr Sirru Allah, that Al-Qadr, the predestination, is from the secret of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one knows about it except Allah. And it cannot be encompassed. It can't be encompassed. And you would not be able to comprehend it. Cannot be comprehended or encompassed. فَلَا تَدْخُلْ فِيهِ بَلْ عَلَيْكَ أَن تُؤْمِنَ بِمَا جَاءَ فِي النُّصُوصِ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ وَالسُّنَّةِ. So the Shaykh, he said, do not enter into it. Do not delve into this affair of argumentation. Why will Allah punish this? Why will not Allah punish this one? Why did Allah do this? And the like. This is not permissible. This is not permissible. So do not enter into this affair. Rather, believe in what came in the text from Al-Kitab was Sunnah. وَقِفْ عِنْدَ هَذَا وَتَوَجَّهْ إِلَى الْعَمَلِ الصَّالِحِ وَتَرْكِ الدُّنُوبُ وَالْمَعَاصِي. He said, you should stop right there. Don't go beyond that. Do not go beyond it. Don't delve into argumentation and all these things. Rather, you should concentrate and focus more on doing good deeds and leaving off sins. وَلَا تَقُلْ إِنْ كَانَ اللَّهُ قَدَّرَ لِي أَنِّي مِنْ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ سِرْتُ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ وَلَوْ مَا عَمِلْتُ شَيْئًا وَإِذَا كَانَ اللَّهُ قَدَّرَ لِي أَنِّي مِنْ أَهْلِ النَّارِ فَسَأَكُونُ مِنْ أَهْلِ النَّارِ فَهَذَا كَلَامٌ بَاطِلٌ. So he said, the Shaykh, he said, don't say that if I am going to be one of the people of paradise, even if I don't do much good, then I will be from the people of paradise. And if I'm going to be from the people of the hellfire, then what's the point? You understand, some people say this. This is not permissible. This is not permissible. Do not enter into these things. Because these are from the affairs of al-qada wal-qadar. Only Allah knows who is going to enter paradise, who is going to enter hellfire. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He does not oppress anyone. He does not oppress anyone, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He gives us a choice. He gives us a choice. We are not compelled to do things against our will. No. Allah gave us a will. So we can either do righteous deed and we can go do bad things. So you have a choice. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He gave you a choice. He created in you faculties. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the faculties of sight, of hearing. He created for you a body. It has two feet. You can walk. You can talk. You can do a lot of good things, but you also can do a lot of bad things as well. Right? So, you have a choice. You either do good or you do evil. But you cannot come on Yawm al-Qiyamah and say, oh Allah, blame al-Qadr on it. La. You cannot blame al-Qadr. You cannot blame al-Qadr. Don't use al-Qadr as an argument. Do not use al-Qadr as an argument. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He established the proof upon us. He sent the messengers, peace be upon them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He gave us intellect. We have an intellect. We have a heart. We had a choice either to do good or bad. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَهَدَيْنَاهُ النَّجْدَيْنِ. And we have guided him to the two paths. Either you're going to walk down the path of good, or you're going to walk down the path of evil. So all these things, alhamdulillah, they have been clarified in the Quran and also in the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So he said, if someone says, now this is kalam batil, this false speech. فلا يجوز الدخول في هذه الأمور لأن هذا ليس من شأن العباد هذا من شأن الله. He said it is not permissible to enter into these affairs because this is not from the affairs of the humans, of the servants. These are from the affairs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. من شأنك العمل هذا هو المطلوب منك. What you have to worry about is to do good deeds. This is what is required of you. أما الدخول في القضاء والقدر فهو دخول في متاهة لا يخرج منها العبد أبدا. He said, because entering into this affair of argumentation in al-qadr, why and how and all this, he said, this will be like someone will get lost in it. Will get lost in it. So he wouldn't be able to come out of it. وقوله منهي عنه عند جميع الفرق لأن القدر سر الله عند جميع الأمم. And the statement of the author, رحمه الله, الإمام البربهاري, that this is impermissible, it is prohibited, means to delve into this affair of al-qadr and argumentation in al-qadr and the like, disputing and the like. So it is something prohibited with all the sects, because al-qadr is the secret of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with all the nations. Sheikh Saleh bin Fuzan al-Fuzan, hafidhahu Allah ta'ala, he said, لأن القدر سر الله والسر لا يمكن الإحاطة به. He said, because القدر predecree is the secret of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And something that is secret, nobody can encompass and nobody can, understand and encompass. As Allah said in the Quran, وَلَا يُحِيطُونَ بِشَيْءٍ مِنْ عِلْمِهِ إِلَّا بِمَا شَاءَ. نعم. لا تدخل في شؤون الله لكن عليك بشؤون نفسك. Sheikh said, do not enter into the affairs of the Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala, but rather you should busy yourself with yourself. عليك بالعمل الصالح وترك الدنوب. What is upon you is to do good deeds and to leave off sins. وبالتوبة منها. And to repent from those sins. وحاسب نفسك ما دمت على قيد الحياة. and put yourself to accountability as long as you are alive. اشتغل ونفسك ونفسك أن أن أما أن أن تشتغل تشغل نفسك بالقضاء والقضاء بالقضاء والقدر ولماذا كان وبماذا يكون وإن كان الله قدر. So the Sheikh is saying that instead of you delving into al-qada wal-qadar, you know, argumentation and dispute in these matters of al-qada wal-qadar, don't do this. Busy yourself with knowledge. Busy yourself with good deeds. Stay away from sins. Make tawbah if you have committed sins. Do not busy yourself with al-qada wal-qadar. Do not busy yourself with this. Like, for example, saying, why is this? And the like. Or saying, وَإِنْ كَانَ اللَّهُ مُقَدِّرَ الْمَقَادِيرَ فَأَنَا لَسْتُ بِحَاجَةِ لِلْعَمَلِ. Or saying that if Allah has already decreed what's going to happen, then why should I even do any good deed? So he said, all this speech is false, is false. وَلَا قِيمَةَ لَهُ, and has no value. وَلَمَّا قَالَ الصَّحَابَةُ لِلرَّسُولِ صَلَى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ أَنَا أَلَا نَتَّكِلُ عَلَى كِتَابِنَا مَا قُدِّرَ لَنَا قَالَ أَعْمَلُوا فَكُلٌ مُيَسَّرُ لِمَا خُلِقَ لَهُ. So when the companions, may Allah be pleased with them, they said, O Messenger of Allah, shouldn't we rely on what is in our record, what Allah decreed for us? He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, no, rather you do good deed. Because everyone was created for that. Either everyone was created, Allah made it easy for him to do good. Others, they want evil. They want evil. Naam? So Allah left them in that path that he had chosen. Naam. Like, for example, وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقِ الرَّسُولِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى وَيَتَّبِعْ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ نُوَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّى وَنُصْلِهِ جَهَنَّمَ وَسَاءَتْ مَصِيرَهُ. Whoever opposes the messenger. So he had a choice, either to accept the message or reject it. He rejected the messenger. He opposes the messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam after guidance has been clarified to him. So this man, he was misguided upon knowledge. After guidance has been clarified to him. And he follows a way other than the way of the believers. Other than the way of the Sahaba. نُوَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّى. We will leave him in that path that he had chosen. And we will land him in the hellfire. And what an evil destination. Subhanallah. طيب. فَأَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى إِنَّ سَعْيَكُمْ لَشَتَّى فَأَمَّا مَنْ أَعْطَى وَاتَّقَى وَصَدَّقَ بِالْحُسْنَى فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْيُسْرَى وَأَمَّا مَنْ بَخِلَ وَاسْتَغْنَى وَكَذَّبَ بِالْحُسْنَى فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْعُسْرَى. So Allah revealed the ayah from Surah Al-Layl. نعم. فأنت تفعل السبب إما في نجاة نفسك وإما في هلاكها. He said, what is upon you is to take the initiatives, to take the means, for your safety. So someone takes the means for his destruction, wal-iyadu billah. So the people, they vary. Some of them, they take the means to save themselves from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By obeying Allah, by obeying his messenger, by performing the salat, giving the zakat, fasting the month of Ramadan, doing good deeds, giving charity and the like. You see, these are the ones that they wanted to save themselves from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Others, they're doing the opposite. وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. They're committing sin and they're going in the wrong way.
The Sheikh said, بأفعالك التي تفعلها باختيارك وإرادتك. He said, you're doing all this with your actions and with your will, with your choice and your will. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, كل الناس يغدو فمعتق نفسه أو مبقها. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, all the people, the endeavor. Either the endeavor to free themselves from the punishment of Allah and the hellfire and the light, or to destroy themselves. Subhanallah. And as Allah said in the Quran, أَفَنَجْعَلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ كَالْمُجْرِمِينَ. Do we make those who submit to us the same as those who are criminals? They are not the same. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us all beneficial knowledge or righteous action. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Sallallahu wa sallam ala Muhammadin wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.